So Ready or Not is launched on Steam's Early Access program for $40 with a support edition DLC that gives you some cosmetic goodies for an extra $80 USD. Originally slated for beta release in June of 2022, Ready or Not is a spiritual successor to SWAT 4 being developed by Void Interactive. The game has had a history with delayed updates, lack of communication from the devs, and a release of the PvP alpha, which was met with less than stellar reviews. The game itself, now in its PvE cooperative state, it's fun as hell. There's 6 assault rifles, 3 SMGs, 3 shotguns, 7 secondaries, including a taser. There's 5 tactical gadgets, including, you know, a mirror gun, breaching shotgun. There's 2 different shields. There's a battering ram. You have access to NVGs and gas masks. Basically, a whole plethora of gear to take onto 6 different maps, ranging from hotels to a meth house. They also give you access to a couple of white box testing levels that look like early versions of Hotel. I'm not sure why those are in the build still, but you can run around and play on them if you'd like, but it's definitely a nice start for a game in early access. And in terms of character customization, the core functionality is there, but there's not a lot to choose from. All told, the entire game has a decent amount of content to start out, and the game itself is actually pretty high quality. I would say AAA in some aspects, such as visuals and audio and gunplay. It feels really, really good to play. Now, the AI definitely needs some tweaking, but jumping in with a group is definitely fun. Earlier in 2021, it was announced that Team 17 had joined in as the publisher for the game, giving Void Interactive the resources and funding to complete the title. However, this no longer seems to be the case. Right now, when you search for Team 17, the Void Interactive page is archived on their website, and on the official Early Access page, Team 17 is no longer listed as a publisher. Fans who purchased from the website earlier on were given a couple different builds of the game, one of which takes you to a Steam page that is now archived and actually has Team 17 listed as the publisher. Something weird is going on between Team 17 and Void Interactive. The game has made huge strides over the last 9 months since the announcement that Team 17 had joined in, and instead of releasing into beta next year like it was planned, the developers have seemingly decided to move that date up, release onto Steam without Team 17 anywhere in sight. Now, this was done, according to the devs, because Steam would not let them generate any more keys to sell on their website. Steam apparently put their foot down and told them to shit or get off the pot, launch on Steam so that you can keep using our services. According to the developers, they were forced to release on Steam so they can continue selling the game on their website. Also to note, if you were purchasing from the website any time over the last 2 or 3 years, you were met with a statement regarding the standard edition pricing of $39.99, in which they say that this is their discounted pre-sale rate and it's 20% off what the early access price is going to be. But when the game launched on Steam, it was the same price. So anybody who pre-ordered in hopes to get in at the cheapest price, kind of shit out of luck. On top of that, if you bought on the website when the game went live on Steam, you had to wait for a key. There were people that were like, I could buy the game on Steam right now, refund on the website, and get in quicker than waiting for the keys. It feels like this was a rushed decision from the devs, and not a lot of thought was really put into the release. Now, the game is getting overwhelmingly positive reviews, which is great, because I think the game actually deserves it, but I still have this weird feeling surrounding this moving up of the release date. I have a weird feeling about the fact that Void Interactive has come out and said that they are banking on selling copies of the game to continue development. And when Void Interactive was contacted on Twitter about what's going on with Team 17, they were met with the response, they can't comment about the Team 17 situation right now. There's an old Steam page, which is soon to be archived, that was for the Alpha Edition. From now on, all updates on both branches will be sent to the new app. And according to Steam support, when it comes to doing something like this, it's actually not allowed. Steam support has been quoted in the past that we can't really support taking down a game and putting up a new version of it, even if you've made some big technological changes. Shipping that extra content and improvements is great, but doing it via a new game with a new store page wouldn't be okay. And it also begs the question as to why this was done in the first place. If a new Steam page has gone up, wouldn't that mean that Void Interactive has lost all of the wish list that the original page had? For now, the game is $40 to pick it up right now. The question you all have for me, I know, is it worth it? After the insane amount of people defending games like Battlefield 2042 and Black Ops Cold War, it's thrown my perspective out on worth. Are you itching for a game that has a decent amount of content, runs well, will hopefully be finished within 12 months, according to their early access Steam page, and is bringing back a SWAT experience that we haven't had in a long time? Then sure, pick it up. If you can wait a bit to see how it plays out, then do that. Evaluate everything that I've said, watch my other gameplays, watch my other evaluations on Ready or Not through the years, and decide for yourself. In the past, I have roasted games that have gone out at $40 when the content just isn't there, but after a couple years of eating shit at full price in the AAA space, I'm sitting here kind of questioning my thought process on this game and other games moving forward. So it's pretty hard to answer, but I feel like with enough information, you guys can decide for yourself. My name is Big Fry. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.